Hello everyone, my name is Disha Mehta, legal intern at Lexis & Company and a law student at Gujarat University. Today we are going to talk about the term plea bargaining. So what it is all about? So plea bargaining in law, the practice of negotiating an agreement between the prosecution and the defense whereby the defendant pleads guilty to a lesser punishment or lesser offense, or in case of multiple offenses to one or more of the offenses charged in exchange of more lenient sentencing recommendations, a specific sentence, or a dismissal of other charges. Supporters of plea bargaining claim that it speeds court proceedings and guarantees a conviction, whereas opponents believe that it prevents justice from being served. Thus, plea bargainings are not always easy to recognize. Negotiations that result in informal agreements are termed explicit plea bargaining. However, some plea bargains are called as implicit plea bargains because they involve no guarantee of leniency. Explicit bargains are the more important of the two. Now, there are types of plea bargains. So, there are three main types of plea bargains. Each type involves the sentence reduction, but those reductions are achieved in very different ways. First of them is the charge bargaining. In charge bargaining, the defendant agrees to plead guilty to a reduced charges, example, aggravated assault rather than attempted murder. Second one is the sentence bargaining. Now, sentence bargaining involves assurance of lighter or alternative sentences in return for a defendant's pleading guilty. One of the most visible forms of sentence bargains occurs when defendant pleads guilty to a murder in order to avoid the death penalty. Sentence bargains also occur in less serious cases, such as pleading guilty to a charge in exchange for a sentence of time served, which generally means that the defendant will be immediately released. And the last type is plea negotiation, or it is called as court bargaining. The third type of plea negotiation is the court bargaining, in which defendants who face multiple charges may be allowed to plead guilty to fewer counts. The charges need not be identical. The prosecutor may drop any charge or charges in exchange for a guilty plea on the remaining charges, because count bargaining applies only to defendants who face multiple charges. It is the least common form of bargaining. Therefore, the research has shown that defendants who plead guilty receive less severe sentences than similarly charged defendants who exercises their right to trial. Statistics have shown that the average sentence following a felony conviction by jury trial is usually much longer than that given to defendants who plead guilty. It appears that merely pleading guilty can reduce one sentence by about 2/3. Thank you.